up, everybody, and welcome back to Two Guys, One Anime. My name is The Holy Apple.
I'm Ashuri.
And this is the top 10 most epic displays of strength in anime by watchmojo. So we have actually kept our eyes on watchmojo because they've had some very interesting list videos that we want to go through. And before this video even starts, I'm going to say that if Gojo Satoru is not in this, because it is 2022, if he's not in this list, I'm going to flip a fucking gasket. And that's monetization gone out the window if we get it.
That's so, an honorable mention count.
What?
An honorable mention. They always do
if
that.
If it's an honorable mention, I am okay with it.
All right. Okay. Okay.
But no, if it's not mentioned at all, I'm going to lose my...
No, that's fair. Right. Okay. Let's see what we get. I'm not even seeing Shaman King.
I've not seen Shaman King. I know it's supposed to be very good, though.
Watchmojo, and these are the top 10 most epic showcases of strength in anime.
Okay. Escanor's got to be in there, isn't he?
Escanor has to be in there.
In anime displayed their superiority to their doing villains. With most cases
resulting in instant death. Dragon Ball Z, isn't it? That's something.
Think we skipped over any...
There's Escanor.
Escanor!
They know.
He better be. Right, let's see this list. Come on.
Go to my Twitter at AshJBo and let me know. Number 10, Squish. Baki. Oliver
okay.
is a man among men.
Yeah,
the
okay, I can get behind this.
In the world,
I know exactly what the scene is.
Moves like this, we can kind of see where he's coming from. During his first match in the Right Eye tournament, Oliver is challenged by a foe who trained his abs to become harder than diamond, making him supposedly
I suppose it is a show of strength.
So
yeah.
What does Oliver do?
It's not powerful fighters. Yeah, it's not powerful fighters. It's
Oliver's
just a show
like one of
strength.
The strongest fighters in the anime.
Yeah. It's a show of strength. That's what you've got to remember.
He casually squishes him like a bug. That's what.
It's overpowered. Just turns to mush,
yes,
basically.
Don't count for much when the rest of your body
the diamond was crushed.
A simple pat of the head. Number 9, the Devil Lance.
Kengan Ashura. I've seen this.
The fights look good. I'm just a little bit off put.
Your style's weird.
Yeah,
the fights.
The fights are good,
though. Stupid enough to step up to him. Then again, Kuroki Gensai is not most fighters. In fact, he's regarded as the deadliest martial artist alive, which he demonstrates by deconstructing Rihito whilst barely moving from one spot.
Nice.
This is within like a minute of the fight.
Stabbed him with his fingers.
Yeah.
And that's when we all learned that the Kratos of anime was not one to be trifled with. It's
the Kratos of anime. I mean, he's not wrong.
Fight scenes are solid.
The fighting is really good, isn't it?
Shaman King.
Shaman King. I've not seen this.
Simple taste, how I've not seen it now, but
his enemies hard and fast and be done with them. Like how he handled this group of ex-laws who thought that they could overcome the might of his guardian ghost. They may have been armed with giant mechanical angels, but nothing the holy radicals put forward came close to the spirit of fire.
I don't know if I can appreciate this one, though, because I don't know how strong the enemies actually are in this anime.
Yeah, it's like, if you haven't seen it, it's kind of difficult to... Yeah.
They might
have looks
been
good.
I mean, don't get me wrong, it's kicking their ass.
Yeah, and it looks amazing.
Number 7, Muzan's management skills. Demon Slayer Kimetsu no Yaiba.
I mean, that's fair play. Don't really look at it like that way, but that's it is a really cool show of strength.
And his own demonic
forces.
It's because the upper six is like he killed the Fire Hashira. And it's like, for him to be that scared of a kid at this point,
screaming and pointing at him so much that his body starts to profusely bleed out.
He's got a point.
Yeah.
It's hard to say. Like literally making him bleed and die just from talking to him. Of
Muzan's capabilities, or that someone as strong as Akaza got reduced to a whipping boy. The fact Muzan is in a child form
yeah, it's,
at the time
it,
just
it was
pushes
that,
the humiliation
that show of strength from
up to 11.
Mugen train like against the Ashura. It's like yeah, he's a bit better
this guy's
than him.
Strong.
Number so six, you're like oh god, no and then it's Yu Yu Hakusho. Over the top.
It's certainly yeah. one way to invite someone
I need to
attend
watch this. Yeah, I want to watch this. And that's why I've come 92 to 94, man.
To be alive Jesus, that's old.
And way more powerful than initially thought, Toguro wastes no time in extending an offer to Yusuke to join the Dark Tournament, where they will be able to settle the score once and for all. He also demolishes an entire parking lot with his bare hands.
That's so cool.
The fact that this anime was made when I was born is just
so
blows my mind.
Solid, yeah, man. It looks so good.
Close to seeing what he's capable of dishing out.
The thing is, though, back then that's probably like one of the peak shows of strength because Dragon Ball was only coming to its like legs at that point.
Yeah,
like, there was no Dragon Ball
Number
Z.
Five, Super Saiyan 3.
See the fact
Dragon
that the Super Saiyan 3, right for Dragon Ball. Talk about is the original Super I would have gone with the original clip of Goku when he's at the first tournament in Dragon Ball, Goku once again and he's fighting. I think he's fighting Tien. First, I thought I'd take him and to he takes off his weighted clothes. In a bit to storm when he's fighting Tien. Goku
unveils yeah, maybe.
And I kind of like that as a show of strength, because everyone's like, oh, this guy's rubbish. And then he takes off his weighted clothes, he's like, oh, that's so much better, and he just rips Tien to shreds.
I tell you what, I might even, like, be willing to put, you should have put the original Super Saiyan in this.
The original Super Saiyan is iconic. Well, it's in this is good, though.
It is good. It's a show of strength.
Yeah. This was Goku's crowning. But you could. The one that I liked was Gotenks. When he's in the he's in the training. They're in the training thing with Piccolo. I'll pause this quickly. He's in the training time capsule with Piccolo, time chamber, and he's obviously he's Gotenks and Trunks when they're kids. And he's like, Piccolo's just like, oh, they're so stupid. Because I think they're getting them ready to fight Boo. Like, that's their secret weapon. And they mix and they're like running around because they're kids being stupid. And then he doesn't even, they don't even mess about. I think they go from instant normal when they're together to Super Saiyan 3. And the excuse was, oh, we saw Vegeta and Goku do it. So we thought we could do it. And I'm just like, I was just
yeah,
like,
pretty much.
I was just like, so mind boggled because obviously Super Saiyan 3 was like at the time one of them things where like oh
it was the crowning like peak of power.
If you can make it, it's amazing. And two kids
like,
just
not
went,
even Vegeta. Yeah, not even Vegeta could do it.
Yeah,
I'll put it that
it's
way.
Like, it's like it's just like two things where it's just like oh we saw Goku do it, so it's like fine, whatever. And it, like Piccolo just sits there, he's like, what have I just witnessed?
It's like, it's like at this point, Gotenks is like leagues above Piccolo in power. Yeah. It's like.
Also, the fact the art design for Gotenks, where his hair is literally pretty much on the floor because he's so short, always like made me look at him and went, "That is so cool." It's untrue. It looks so good, but yeah, there's a lot for Dragon Ball Z that you could have.
Yeah, there's a lot of moments you could pick for iconic moments. But the original Super Saiyan 3 one's not bad. I'll give
them
that.
It's got one of the best songs. As well, so, but yeah, for number four, One Piece. One Piece.
There's countless reasons to love
this
guy,
from his skill in
battle,
his friendship with Roger, all the way to how he really gave his own life. Oh,
you just can't remember it because it's so much.
Oden swiftly endeared himself to all, establishing himself as a power player within Oda's world, whose lore and influence continue to have a profuse impact on the series' latest shining arc. However, Odin's boss moment is understandably
right.
When he was forced to bathe in boiling
it's cool,
oil
but just
for
pause it a second. For feet of power, if you're going to use One Piece, I would probably have done it where Luffy has the time skip, so like they get defeated like midway through one of the seasons, and it's like a 2-year time skip, and Luffy goes into one of like the highest security prison, Ippledown, I think it's called, and there's like a whole training arc behind it and everything. But basically, after 2 years, they like the old crew reunites.
Yeah.
And Luffy fights one of the security things that absolutely stomped the entire crew last time. Luffy solos it in one punch. That's like, that is like an ultimate show of strength just because of how far they actually came. I would have used that personally.
I've not seen One Piece, but isn't there one with Zoro as well where he's getting slashed?
Yes, there is one.
Which
with,
is
not even that. Zoro, when he fights Pika, which is like a giant stone mountain thing, cuts him in half in one slash.
Yeah, I mean, that's a show of strength. Like,
yeah. There's a lot of loads you can use in One Piece. I personally want to use this one. There's
I mean, he's literally holding up.
It is good. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not
going to downplay it, but there are, in my eyes, better ones you could use.
Yeah.
I'd use the Zoro one. I'd use Luffy one punching one of the enemies that was the strongest at that point.
Yeah. That's fair.
And then not to mention, you've got things like the elephant gun when he uses it for the first time and just destroys everything.
Hmm.
But there's loads of options.
Yeah, no, that's fair,
Power, whilst holding up his retainers over his head.
Maybe it's because he's burning as well. They've looked at that, kind of thing.
And that doesn't matter. Like, you'll find out very...
Reversing the laser. Fire Force. When you can't answer his duties as a protector.
I've not seen Fire Force yet. But we really do want to watch it. It looks good.
Of a feat like this. As Nataku loses control of his Adola burst, he unleashes a nuclear blast condensed into the form of a laser that could easily wipe out the entire cast. Until Charon steps in.
I remember Charon being an absolute arsehole up to this point.
Not only does he take the full force of the blast,
so a bit like a Vegeta then.
He's a bit like a Vegeta.
Yeah. Into the sky. And all he lost was his shirt. Whatever the order of the Ashen Flame.
I mean, this is fair enough for Fire Force as a show of strength. Because that was supposed to be like the equivalent of a nuclear blast.
Yeah. It looks so solid.
Praise the sun or die.
Yeah, Escanor. Man!
Definitely a flex.
Wrong one, though, if it's this bit.
Yeah, it's probably this bit.
Obviously,
that's unfortunate, but fair enough.
The bit against, I can't remember his name, the big guy who wears the blue, got the black hair.
Yes, I know what you mean.
When he like says about him, he's like, "Oh, you just can't do anything," and he just smacks him and sends him flying. That bit.
It's not only that.
He's got the same attack and he can reverse it.
He's got full counter,
and he hits himself and he goes, "Oh, I wondered why that hurt. It was me who did it." I was like,
"Yeah, it's like,
so
oh,
good.
That must be how strong I am."
Yeah. So good. You know,
the ultimate flex for Escanor. This is an incredible scene for Escanor. The best one is when he stands up to Demon King Meliodas and he just goes through Sun God mode.
Yeah.
That is like, you can't beat him.
Is that the bit where they're locked in the bubble as well?
Yes.
Yeah.
Locked in the bubble, and then the pinnacle happens.
Yeah, it's
and he
iconic.
Just literally goes, "You can't beat me," and nothing can be done.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like the ultimate flex in anime.
So
as far
good.
As
I'm glad he's in it, though, to be fair. So.
Yeah, it's a good pick.
Yeah.
Number one, punching away the ocean. Sengoku Buzzera,
punching away the
kings.
I think I've heard of this actually.
In anime, there's the ridiculous, and then there's Hideyoshi Toyotomi. After declaring himself ruler, the giant of a man set out on a campaign to conquer everything in his path, and wasn't about to let a little thing like the sea get in the way of his new domain. So he does what every great leader does. He punches it with such force that everything becomes barren.
I promise that you will meet your doom this day!
That sounds like Christopher Sabat.
Maybe.
That
100%. He cleared out an entire ocean with just one punch. How did this guy even...
One punch!
...strong enough to reshape the planets?
Wow. That's actually cool, I'm not going to lie.
That's fair enough.
That's cool. I would like to argue... I would like to argue... Not if you could say it's a full show of strength, but... And I probably would have put it quite high. But I would have liked to have seen Levi when he goes against the Beast Titan, where he starts like going from Titan to Titan.
and he just got attacking everyone down.
Yeah, I feel like that's like that was a real for me. That was a really cool moment of like showing how strong Levi is. Hmm. You could have, like, an honorable mention would have been fair. Like, there was no honorable mentions, which shocked me. But that could have been an honorable mention.
Another one I throw into the mix as well is literally the Flame Shearer against the upper three, rather than Mugen.
Yeah.
Because when, even the the finale of it, it shows how strong he actually is. Because at the end of it, it's just pure strength.
Yeah.
But, yeah, there's multiple ones you could put in there. Inuyasha, there's probably a couple of moments you could put in there for that. Helsing would be another one. In terms of strength, it's not physical strength, but like how strong Alucard actually is.
No, they put in Muzan, and they put in, it's literally, his, you know, they said it was his organization.
Yeah, mental ability.
I rate that, because you could maybe do that for Dr. Stone. In certain, there was probably a certain moment in that you could probably do for that, in terms of, like, brain strength,
IQ,
like how smart he was.
He doesn't really have, like, a strength feat where it's like he is overpowered kind of thing. So,
no, but obviously, that,
about overpowered.
Yeah, I don't know.
I was gonna say, like, you could even have Overlord. They have Einzoom Goal, and he uses super tier magic for the first time.
Mm.
He literally nukes one of the strongest characters in the anime and takes out like half her health in one shot.
Mm.
So it's like it's kind of understood to be a really powerful feat, but it wasn't in there, which is
true.
I know it's obviously top 10, and they're very limited. And when you look at like anime over the last 30 years, there's a lot.
On top of that, they've not seen everything. So it's like you can only go with what you know. So it's fair enough. And it is a very good list because I've never seen number one. And I'm now very interested to see number one. So
overall, I'm quite happy with the entries. There's obviously a couple that I would swap for others. But
yeah, but you can.
Overall, very good list. So if you did enjoy this as well, by all means, the WatchMojo video link is going to be in the description down below.
Yeah.
But obviously, let us know what you think in the comments below as well. Like, did you enjoy this format of video? Should we do more? And obviously, tell us if there's anything that you'd like us to check out. We'd be more than happy to go have a look. But that is going to be everything from us. And my camera moved again. But that's going to be everything from us. Thank you very much for watching. And we shall see you in the next video.
Bye.